Fresh. Go DJ, that's my DJ. Go DJ, that's my DJ. Go DJ, that's my DJ. Go DJ.
Yo, 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 this is Mr. O, and today we're gonna learn double and half angle identities, okay? First, we have to know what is the formula, or what are the formulas of double and half angle identities. Here are the formulas for the half angle. It's also all written here. If you will notice, there are three possible ways to write tangent, half angle, and same thing with the double angle for cosine, okay? So make sure you have a copy and you familiarize yourself in working on problems for double and half angle identities. So I know you're so excited. Let's go ahead now. So if you're given cosine theta is equal to 8 over 17 and 3 pi over 2, or the theta is between 3 pi over 2 and 2 pi, find sine 2 theta, okay? So first, we know, let's identify first the quadrant here. That is talk about the fourth quadrant, right? So therefore, in our fourth quadrant, okay, this is the reference angle or theta. This is your adjacent or 8, and 17 is your hypotenuse, okay? That's a right triangle. So we're gonna need Pythagorean theorem to find this side here. That will give us 8 squared plus x squared is equal to 17 squared. Using Pythagorean theorem there, it will give us 225, and x there is equal to 15. Actually, it's not really x there. That should be the y, you know. But that's 15, the missing side, okay? Since it's fourth quadrant, we know that sine theta there is going to be negative 15 over 17, okay? Now we can apply and find the sine 2 theta, and the formula for sine 2 theta is right here. Imagine that the A there is a theta, that's theta, that's theta, that's theta, okay? So 2 sine theta cosine theta, so therefore to find the sine 2 theta is equivalent to 2 sine theta cosine theta, okay? So therefore this will be now the double angle of sine 2 theta is 2. What is the sine theta in this problem? Theta, sine theta of this problem is negative 15 over 17. Cosine theta is right there, is already given 8 over 17. We multiply sine, we multiply 2, negative 15 over 17, and 8, 17. The answer is negative 240 over 289. On this case here, we cannot reduce it anymore. So that's the final answer. Okay. Next. If the problem, let's say there's a follow-up question. Let's say the follow-up question is find also cosine 2 theta. In cosine 2 theta, you again, you have three options there. You can use whatever you want. Okay. On this case here, I'm going to use this item because I only have one thing to worry. The formula for that is 2 cosine squared theta minus 1. Since I know already what's cosine, which is 8 over 17 squared minus 1, that will easily give me, let's use our calculator here, 264, 17 squared is 289, and then you're going to multiply 2 by 64. That's obviously going to be equal to 289 minus 1. We know it's minus 1 there. This will give us 128 minus 289 over 289. And minus by 289, 161. Negative 161 over 289. Divide by 289. Do they have any like terms? Or nope, that's it. So negative 161 over 289 is the answer for cosine 2 theta. Again, you can use any formula for cosine 2 theta or the double angle, and you should get the same answer. Next, one more. Sine theta is equal to negative 1/3, and the angle is between theta and 3 pi over 2. That means that is in the third quadrant, okay? So that's the third quadrant. Here's our triangle. This is the negative 1. That's a 3. The reference angle is right here. This is a 90. We have to look for the value of x there. using Pythagorean theorem, we will get negative 1 squared plus x squared is equal to 3 squared. That will give us x squared is equal to 8, so therefore x equal to 2 squared of 2. Now, therefore, we can say that the tangent theta is opposite over adjacent. Opposite is negative 1 over 2 squared of 2. Or if we rationalize that one, that will give us square of 2 over 4, okay? And that will be positive, okay? That will be positive. It should be positive 1 there. The reason why being, like, why is it positive? It's not negative. Because this is the square of 2, the 2 square of 2 is also going to be negative there because that's an x-axis. So negative divided by negative will be positive, okay? All right, so tangent to theta. Okay, let's look at the formula again. We're going to use this formula here. 2 tangent A over 1 minus tangent squared A. So this will be now 2 tangent of theta over 1 minus tangent. No, not squared. Tangent squared theta. Okay, so 2 tangent theta here is square of 2 over 4. All over 1 minus square of 2 all over 4 squared. Okay, that's basically the question, okay? So let's work on the numerator first. This will be 2 and 4 will cancel out, right? That will just give you 1 half. So this will be square of 2 all over 2. All over, and we know we're going to square this. So 1, the square of this one here is going to be 2 over 16. Okay, I'm going to write my work here. So that will give us now square of 2 over 2. And we know that the square of 16, 2 over 16 here is the same thing as 1 8, right? And instead of having a 1 here, I'm going to have 8 over 8. That will leave me a 7 over 8. And dividing fraction by a fraction, we'll get the reciprocal of the denominator, square of 2 over 2, times 8 over 7. We can cancel and simplify 8 over 2, which will give you a 4 and a 1. So the correct answer is 4 square of 2 over 7. Okay, we're good with that one. Now let's go to half angle identities. Note to determine the sign, determine the quadrant in which the half angle lies. Okay, before I go there, remember the formula for half angle. We have three possible formulas for tangent, and we have it's for cosine and sine. The cosine and sine are very similar. One is plus, one is minus. And take note, for this formula, there's a plus or minus, okay, coming from a square root, okay? So be careful and minded of those things, okay? So for half angle, cosine 67.5, 67.5 is in which quadrant can we locate this one? This is in the first quadrant, right? So we know that cosine, if you double 67.5, okay, 67.5, if you double that one, is equal to 135. So therefore, cosine of 135 divided by 2 is equivalent to cosine 67.5, right? Now, applying the formula here, we can say that cosine theta over 2 plus or minus the square root of 1 plus cosine theta. The theta here is 135, cosine of 135 all over 2. Plus or minus, what is the cosine 135? Cosine 135 is negative square of 2 over 2, right? So this becomes now, the plus becomes minus here because it's negative square of 2 over 2, okay? This should be a bigger square root, all over 2, okay? So now we have plus or minus of that. We can combine this in a single fraction. This would be just 2 over 2 here. That becomes 2 minus square of 2 all over 2. And this 2 here in the bottom has an all over 2. Remember, there's an invisible 1 there. So therefore, you have plus or minus the square root of 2 minus square of 2 over 2 times 1 half. Because we reciprocate the denominator, right? Let me write my answer on this side here. All right, let me move the red room there. There you go. So therefore, we have now plus or minus the square root of 2 minus square root of 2 times 1 is the same thing all over 4. But what is square root of 4? Square root of 4 is same thing as plus or minus 2 minus square root of 2 all over 2. And that's the answer for the half angle or cosine 67.5. Okay. Next. What if we have sine 11 pi over 2? 11 pi over 2, you know, 11 divided by 2 is kind of like 0.91. So that's very close to our whole pi. So we know that this one will be in the second quadrant. Again, the first thing you're going to do is find the quadrant, okay? So for you to know the sine value, okay? Next, sine 11 pi over 2 can be done by using 11 pi over 6 divided by 2. Why over 2? Because remember, there's an over 1 here. When you divide a fraction by a fraction, this becomes 11 pi over 6 times 1 half. And that becomes 6 times 2, which is going to be 12. 11 pi times 1 is 11 pi. So this is the format that we're going to use. Okay. So again, one more time, the sine 11 pi over 2, which is in the second quadrant, can be written as sine 11 pi over 6, which is in the unit circle, over 2. So that's your theta, okay? And for the formula for the sine theta over 2, we know that plus or minus the square root of 1 minus cosine of 11 pi over 6 all over 2. On this case here, guys, that 11 pi over 6 is in the fourth quadrant, and the cosine there should be positive, and the answer there is square of 3 over 2. Although there's a minus outside, so it will become negative divided by 2. Again, we get to combine them in a single fraction, so this will become 2 minus square of 3 all over 2, all over 2, over 1, right? And again, we're going to get the reciprocal of the denominator. This becomes now 2 minus square root of 3 all over 2 times 1 half. 2 times 2 is 4. So this becomes now plus or minus the square root of 2 minus square root of 3 all over 4, which we know the square root of 4 is over 2. Okay. And that is our answer for this. Okay. All right. Last question. If sine theta is equal to negative 12 over 13 and the angle theta is between 3 pi over 2 and 2 pi, we're talking about the theta here to be in the fourth quadrant. Okay. But the half angle, according to my initial instruction to you, to determine the sine, determine the quadrant in which the half angle lies. So we have to find the half angle here. So we get a divide by 2, divide by 2, divide by 2. So therefore, it will become 3 pi over 4 and pi here, which will fall on the second quadrant, right, for the half angle, okay? So, but before we go there, we know this is sine theta. That is still in theta, not half angle. That is still going to be on the fourth quadrant. That's why this is negative 12 and that's 13. This is my 19. This is my reference angle. Using Pythagorean triples or Pythagorean theorem, this will become positive 5. So therefore, our cosine theta is going to be equal to positive 5 over 13. Take note, this is the theta, not the half angle. Okay. Now, we are subject to find for the tangent theta or the half angle of the theta over 2. And we know that there are the formula for tangent theta over 2 is right here. You have three options there. And for this case, I will pick, which one do you want here? I'll pick this one here, the last one. Okay, 1 minus cos over sine A, okay? So it will be now 1 minus cosine of theta over sine theta. Take note, this is not the half angle, but that's the regular theta. So it will be now 1 minus the cosine theta is given to be 5 over 13. And sine theta is negative 12 over 13. Same thing, we're going to keep them in the same fraction here. So this will be now 13 over 13, which will give us 8 over 13 all over negative 12 over 13. And again, when we're dividing a fraction by a fraction, we're going to get the reciprocal of the denominator, 13 over negative 12. The 13 cancel out. So what's left is negative 8 over 12. And they're both divisible by what number? 4. That gives us negative 2 over 3. And that's how you apply and solve for the half angle for tangent. And again, as always, kaboom.